we can learn and what we can give back to our parent institution, our employer. That is very, very important. So today we are going to talk about displacement in research and prevention. But I would request, if you have any question related to the research data management, research organizing, research, anything, you can ask me, you know, once this session is over. Even your article processing charges, how to get web off, what are the publication trends, where you should publish, how you should publish. There are, you know, many things which will be in your mind. So this is just a 1.5 hour, you know, session. And so it might, there are many things I may not cover. But if you anything you are happy to, you know, I'll be happy if you ask such questions during the question answer session. And I also believe, you know, this giving an online demonstration. So that was the reason organizer has also requested me. So what I will do, I have a 30 to 45 minute PPT presentation. And then I will give a live demonstration of the Turnitin. There are two very popular anti-plagiarism softwares in India. One is Turnitin. Another one is the Urkund. Now new name is Original. Earlier it was known as Urkund. It is provided by this Ministry of Education through InfibNet. And what I heard is now the Turnitin is also, you know, going to acquire this complete Original means Urkund software. So I'll also discuss why there are so many software, why to go with open, why not to go with open source, why to put paid software, all those things. I'll open my PPT in 2-3 minutes. I just want to discuss, you know, few things. So as the topic is, you know, displacement in research and prevention. So as we know now, you know, there is a this UGC guidelines, what we should do, what we should not do. There are level 0, 1, 2, 3. Then they have also provided, you know, anti-plagiarism softwares. So now nobody is excuse ki, oh, we don't have software, how we will, especially for the government organizations they have provided. I'll also tell you how you can, if you are a private organization, how you can avail such facilities. And then the guidelines. So I would say this is the very, very rare. I think around 15 to 20 countries are also only having this such, you know, clear-cut guidelines. So you know with your thesis, what is going to happen if you are going to submit. If you have more than 10% similarity, you will be asked to revise. So I would say you should feel happy, you know, that guidelines are very clear. And you know what is going to happen if there is a similarity. So that case, you take it as a positive side, ki things are very clear. So that is what I always advise, you know, our research scholar. We have around 560 research scholars who work day and night in our institutions. And just 10 years of times, we have a 2,500 research publication. So we always tell, you know, till, you know, you get below 10, you don't submit. Because once you submit, it is not in your hand. So till you submit, it calls similarity. But once you submit and get published, it will call as a plagiarism. Then nothing is your hand. UGC guideline says ki you will be requested, you will be asked to withdraw from the publisher. But let me tell you, it is not easy to withdraw any publication from the publisher. They will ask you genuine reason. And you know, publishers are also keeping, you know, record of such authors, you know, those who are having these unethical practices like parallel submitting to, you know, various publishers. Generally, we are in impression, you know, that nobody knows nothing, but they have all the track, you know, they have all the keeping track of all those things. But I am happy to share that, you know, earlier our rejection rate was 83% from India research publications. But I am happy to say it has come down to 61%. So now we have a quality research is going on. And, you know, people are very much aware. They are making use of software. They're very much, you know, particular. And we know now every institute, there is an ethical committee, research ethical committee. So they know the consequences. Even there is a small mistake, you know, committee will call. And for us, for academicians, for faculty members, reputation is more important. So even you have a one paper in a year, it is fine. But that paper should be a quality paper. And as we know, due to this open access trend, there are a lot of predatory publishers. I think we know everybody. That is the reason UGC has come with the UGC care list. So I think you are aware of those things, but still you might be getting, you know, few emails in your inbox. Oh, please submit your paper, you know, in our journal. And all those things, you know, the rest of the things. And they may also say, you know, indexed by UGC care list. And few of us may not really go and check whether it is really indexed in the UGC care list. And we also know there are clone journals. For example, there is a journal, say like IPS Academy of, you know, basic sciences. IPS Academia basics. They will say journal of IPS Academia basics. They will just add, you know, one word, so you may not realize. You say, oh, it looks like, you know, I know this journal is published by IPS Academia. So you will submit your article. And I have personally seen, when I did one study, very good articles, they end up with publishing predatory journals because they are not knowing the consequence unintentionally. Very good articles. Now, many people have a question, you know, UGC care list has come years back. What will happen to our articles, to those journals which are now considered as predatory? But by that time, they were not, you know, as a predatory journals. And, you know, this UGC care list, they review every year this list. So suppose this journal is there, you got your article published, but after 1 year, when you know that journal goes off from the UGC care list, whether what will happen to your article which you already published? Well, so all those things we will discuss, and you may also ask me. And generally, I also strongly suggest, when you have to check your PhD thesis, you have to submit to South Ganga, your university, you should always, you know, check through this original, it is known as Orkun software. But if you are going to submit your article, if you are going to submit your manuscript to any academic publishers like Cambridge, Oxford, YLA, IEEE, or any other, you know, society journal, you should, this is my this thing, you should always try to check in Turnitin. Because see how this software works, their backend library. Like Turnitin, their backend library is very strong. Like I did a one study, same manuscript I checked in various, you know, softwares. Like 5-6 manuscript I checked in all the software. So there is a percentage difference. For example, if you check your H index in Web of Science, you check your H index in Scopus, it will be different because their number of journals indexed by them are different. If you check in Google Scholar, it will be different. Same thing is here. See the backend library, for example, if you check same manuscript in say like Urkund, it will show 22%. If you check in Turnitin, 29%. If you check in Authenticate, 31%. Though we know the honor of the Turnitin and this Authenticate, both are same. But why there is a slight difference? Because it also takes the papers in pipeline. You know, submitted manuscript, which are not considered, not accepted. That also it checks. Then Turnitin, there are also option for checking the students' projects and all. So I'll just discuss, I'll try to, you know, include more and more these things. So let me now share my PPT presentation. Here. And I'll share my PPT with the organizer. So if you organize this, they can share the PPT with all the participants. I request someone to please confirm whether my PPT is visible.
It's visible, sir.
So as you can see in this photograph, this is our library of ISER Bhopal. And if anyone who are in, you know, if you are in campus, please visit. We have beautiful campus. It's a new institution, just 10 years old. And one more thing, if anybody, you know, have like Urkund, most of you are having the access to Urkund, but you want to check any manuscript in Turnitin, you can just, this is my email ID. You are always welcome. I feel happy to, you know, help the. Even if you have any question related how to download, you know, articles, ebooks, later on you can ask me, you can note down your questions. I'll try to reply those. So this is the things. I once again congratulate for having this such a wonderful this 1 week program. And all I forgot to mention about the President IPS Academy, Achal K. Chaudhary, Patron Principal Ma'am, Dr. Premlata Ma'am, and convener Dr. Pradeep Joshi, head department of mathematics and the organizing team. So as I think I already discussed about the background, you know, that why actually UGC has to come with the certain guidelines, because there are a lot of things were happening. People were parallelly submitting the, you know, article, this manuscript to the various journals. And then, you know, so this problem actually has several dimensions, like, you know, cheating causes, unfair relationship between cheating and non-cheating students. And this actually, you know, let me tell you my experience, it happens more with the, not with the faculty member, with the students doing this project work. Because, you know, they are actually, many of them even, they are not aware of actually the, you know, the essence of research. So they just, you know, take the material from the internet and, you know, so that is the reason in like my institute, now it is compulsory. you know, their similarity should be more less than 5%. Otherwise, you know, it is not being accepted. So these are the, you know, problem has very dimensions. So as I say, I'll be sharing my PPT with all of you. So I'll be sharing, I'll be skipping few these theoretical slides because I know I believe in more in, you know, live demonstration. So as I talk about research ethics, so as you know, nowadays, you know, when publishers like in article, suppose there are 10 authors, right? So pehle aap log ne suna hoga ki, you know, somebody was telling you, oh, I was a co-author, I was not aware. It has happened with big people. I think you know the names. I did not take the name. So now what author publisher is doing, they are, when they're communicating with, they are keeping all other authors in loop, or they are also sending an email to co-author that, you know, this manuscript, your name is there. If you have any issue, click on this. If you are, you know, not agree with this. So those things are there. So ethical decisions, you know, making in academic research basically focuses on providing maximum benefit to the participant. So basically research ethics, you know, we need to follow all those ethical practices. And, you know, sometimes like somebody says, you know, it is that another faculty member is working on my research. So there are, you know, many kind of issues will come, and sometimes a librarian will be asked to, you know, cross verify all those things. So there are a lot of things, you know, involved in this. So these are the unethical practices like duplication submission, salami slicing, not, you know, then you are taking any photographs, you are not acknowledging, because we know when you know, take any, put any photographs in the manuscript, it doesn't consider as a similarity. But being ethical practice, we need to, you know, give the source where, from where we got. For example, you take any photograph from Google. So Google, if you see, if you go to Google photo search engine, there is one camera. So there you upload that photo, it will show you the, you know, source from where, who has uploaded. So all those things, you know, you can always mention in your manuscript. Then we also need to understand, you know, what is scholarly communication, because before we move to the similarity and all those things, manuscript. So, you know, whatever we communicate, whatever we do the research, why we do research? We do the research for the betterment of the society. For example, we have a vaccine in our hand because of the hard work of our researcher, of our faculty members, right? So that is the reason we have a vaccine today. So we know this takes a lot of time. So what is scholarly communication? Whatever, you know, we do research, we have a new idea and we communicate through research articles. Through research articles through, you know, books, through proceedings. So that is all about the scholarly communication. I request the admin to please mute to all the participants. And I always, you know, like being a librarian, what we do, we keep taking a lot of, you know, orientation classes for students. We tell them about a lot of, you know, this various research support tools, you know, like this is also one of the research support tools, because, you know, I always believe our faculty members, even like the faculty member at IPS Academy or Institute of Science and Research, they're very much busy, you know, with the teaching, with the research and with the administrative work. And I know personally, because you know, this teaching, online teaching has put a lot of time, you know, for the faculty members, because, you know, you have to take online class, you have to take, also share the manuscript, you are writing, you know, these notes to them, you have to evaluate them. So it's very, very, you know, time consuming thing. So in this scenario, I say, if there are research scholars attending my session, it is your duty to, you know, have the you know, expertise in such research support tools. Like today we are talking about this, there are many, like there is a Mendeley, there is a Zotero, there is a Grammar, many softwares, Grammarly, then SciFinder, Web of Science, Scopus, and so many. And let me tell you one thing, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So let me tell you also one thing before I forget here. You know, I am also talking about, apart from my topic, because I thought, you know, just to share my expertise, because I am in this profession for last 23, 24 years. This visibility of research communication, let me tell you, this is especially for the faculty members. See, we are doing a lot of, you know, hard work when we write a manuscript. Lekin hota kya hai ki, once, you know, हम जब एक मैनुस्क्रिप्ट लिखते हैं उसके बाद जब पब्लिश हो जाता है, हम दूसरे मैनुस्क्रिप्ट की तरफ यू नो वी स्टार्ट वर्किंग. बट हियर वी डू द मिस्टेक्स. आई हैव सीन यू नो इन अब्रॉड अदर यूनिवर्सिटीज, यू नो स्पेशली व्हेन यू आर सीइंग द दिस टॉप 2% यू नो साइंटिस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. देयर वाज वन स्टडी राइट फ्रॉम द, आई थिंक इट वाज फ्रॉम द प्रिंसटन, एंड देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट्स, लॉट ऑफ कंप्लेंट्स आल्सो. सो व्हाट आई हैव सीन ड्यूरिंग दैट माय स्टडी दैट यू नो दिस स्पेशली द research scholars in other universities, after their manuscript got get published, they you know publicize their manuscript like anything. They publish on the Twitter, you know, even they make a LinkedIn account for their manuscript, and then they have a, you know, account like on the Judo's, Humanity Commons, Mendeley profiles, and then of course if you have an IRNA, then your profile will be there. So many other platform, you know, they visualize their research. And then they have account. Of course, you should have account like on Google Scholar and then Microsoft Academics. And I always say, you know, like we have an Aadhaar ID. Everybody should have an ORCID ID, because you know that is the platform. You know, it takes by using your ORCID ID, you can open, see your publication on Web of Science platform or Scopus platform, right? So these are the basic things. You know, it's very necessary being a scholar. You know, so that is the best way you can communicate to the society. Okay, before I move forward, I thought, you know, just to talk about what are the things, because many people, they have confusion about referencing, references, citations. So suppose I take a, you know, one paragraph from say like Prem Latha ma'am. So what I will do, I'll just say quote unquote. What I will do, I'll say quote unquote in my one paragraph. So that is actually citation. I will cite her paper. So when I cite her paper, I have to say here quote unquote, like I take this paragraph and bracket, I will say you know Prem Latha comma or Gupta comma 2019. So this kind of what, whenever you cite, you have to give all those things in the reference part, right? Then there is a one more, this whole process is called referencing. Citation, I think, you know, when we take as it is, one more thing, when you put any citation in your paper with a quote unquote, it is not considered as a similarity. Because you are putting quote unquote means you are not claiming your original idea. That is the reason software do not consider this as a similarity as per the UGC guideline. Why UGC guidelines is this, your references will not be considered, bibliographies will not be considered as a similarity, because there is no original idea. I hope you are getting my point, right? It takes only when you know you. Hello.
Your voice is not so clear, sir. Sorry, sir, for interruption. Your voice is not so clear, sir.
Okay. Can you ask the other participant whether
sir, it is clear? Lecture bahut zyada information hai on, sir.
It is clear, sir. It is very clear.
It's clear, sir.
So, ma'am, what I suggest you can again, you know, probably log out and log in. I think that then the other participant says it is clear. Okay. So you can stop me if you feel I am going in other, you know, okay, because sir. I always yes. Okay, so as per the UGC guidelines, if you you know cite any paper and make quote unquote, you know, then always it is. Then many people may, you know, ask how much percentage, you know, you can cite in your original. See, it depends on the your PhD guide. It is the decision of the faculty member. If they feel that you know it is very much necessary in your paper, you go ahead. Up to 30%, there is no problem. Okay, it is not written anywhere, but as per I, you know, like I am also in few editorial, and I discussed too, because many of our faculty members are very editorial boards of big journals. So they say if they feel it is very much necessary, you know, you can go ahead and quote those things with the cite now. So this is all about citation. We know there are various citation styles, right? So one of the citations, so that is the reason when you are writing any thesis, you make sure that you know your university or your college is having any defined, you know, style. Like there are many styles. I'll share my then bibliography. See, bibliography generally, you know, when you are writing, especially PhD thesis, you have to be at the last. What are the references? You know, you have gone through. You not make those use, but you know you have gone through. So that is called as a bibliography. Now let me come to the my presentation. It's already 12. I think I have to wind up by 1. So this, I think everybody knows, due to internet, you know, is made easier everybody to plagiarize. But let me tell you, because of internet only, it is easier to catch also, right? Even you forget about the software. If you have any manuscript, just take one of a paragraph, put in the Google. You will come to know from where, you know, it has been copied and all. So generally the question comes, why people plagiarize? So of course, the first reason is, you know, there is a pressure if you want to have from assistant to associate, associate to professor. So there are certain guidelines. Then, you know, due to the laziness, lack of time. So these are the various issues are there. Now, what is plagiarism? So it means the appropriation of another person's idea, process, results, or words without giving appropriate credit. Suppose, for example, I'll come to the, like, say, like Dr. Pradeep Joshi. He has written a one paper on data science, right? Basics of data science. Now I'm going to write a paper, application of data science, okay, in academic institutions. So what I will do, I'll see, oh, his paper is very good. So I will take one of, you know, two of his paragraph, and I will not, you know, quote him. I'll just take, you know, as it is, it looks like my, I'll just change few wordings and all. You know, there are the softwares also. I put the paragraph, it will completely change the, you know, context. I'll show you one example. So that also, you know, such softwares are available. So that case, if I take his idea, basically, I may not take his, you know, the word to word, but I take his whole idea about data science, you know, the concept of data science, and I show as mine. So that is, you know, actually is a plagiarism. So plagiarism is the act of stealing. Hum bolte isko Hindi mein sahityik chori. Kisi ka idea leke apna idea hoke batana. So that is, you know, the stealing someone else's idea and attempting to pass it off as your own. There are various definitions. I'm not going, you know, in details. You may go. So this is like, you know, first this like appropriation means using or taking something that is not yours. Plagiarism is stealing by using another person's idea or academically dishonest because student, scholars and faculty members are expected to do their own work. Like then the words mean copying more than 14 words. As per the UGC guideline, up to 14 words, no issue. But more than 14 words, then a complete thing will be counted. Ideas, you know, basically, suppose I'm giving a talk on some, say, for example, say One Nation, One Subscription, and somebody quote that idea and don't, you know, give a citation, a credit to acknowledgement to me. So then it is a similarity. Processing, like, you know, lab particular, how to, you know, making a molecule or how to make a protein in the lab. And I copy some, I take the idea process, how they are doing, and I show it my own. And then results also, I take some copy, somebody data, figure. So see, the bottom line is that, you know, whenever you take something, some idea, there is no harm to acknowledge. You should always acknowledge. And if you take any text, you know, you may quote unquote. I think this is the best practice we all should follow. Now, what are the types of, you know, plagiarism? Like, for example, there is a one, you know, speaker is giving a talk in the audience and we are attending. Once I come back to the home, I take her idea and, you know, I write in my research project. That is a similarity. That is a plagiarism. Yes, if I do not cite her, if do not acknowledge her. If I take something from articles and do not acknowledge, yes, definitely yes. If you are reviewing, this also happens few times, you know, you are reviewing a manuscript and you keep on hold and, you know, put that, you know, research as your own research. So the, yes, that is also a, this is a highly, you know, considered as a highly unethical practice also. Then taking anything from internet, yes. You know, somebody, you know, we are discussing each other and then, you know, without giving credit, yes. Copy paste, definitely, yes, is very, you know, popular. Then there are types of plagiarism like copying and then, you know, these are the certain example. Patchwork is also, you know, making some changes here and there. Then paraphrasing. So this type of paraphrasing is, you know, this plagiarism is called paraphrasing plagiarism. This occurs when the plagiarizer paraphrases or summarize another verse without citing the source. Even changing a word little or using synonyms. I'll give the example. See, like there is a one site, spinboard.com. Okay. So this is the one site. There is one more site, like free article. There are various, you know, it's called spin tools. You know, so basically they change the words. So I'm not showing this, you know, you should make a use. But being a faculty member, you should be aware that, you know, if any student do this, you know, you can always, you know, catch them. And for research scholars, you know, you should be aware, if you come to know such, you should be aware that, you know, faculty members are also aware of such tools. Okay. So it is the best policy you use your original idea. So how actually these two works, tools, like you put one paragraph over here, original. Suppose this is a paragraph written by Dr. Pradeep. Okay, now I want to, you know, make some paraphrase, some changes. So what I will do after putting, I will say run. So this text will come. So it says, I certify that all copyright materials incorporate into this document is in dot, dot, dot. It will say, I affirm that I copyright material joined. So it basically, you know, it use synonyms like certify, affirms, incorporated, joined. So even Dr. Pradeep may also not realize that, you know, it is his own actually, you know, work somebody has written in this way. Anyway, so then there is a, you know, types unintentional, you know, by mistake we are not knowing, but let me tell you now, there is no place for unintentional, you know, because there is a software, there is a lot of things, you know, so it's very difficult to convince, you know, to the someone that, you know, it was unintentional. No, there is a one more very popular, that is a self plagiarism, right? Suppose I written a paper on, say, like you know, artificial intelligence, use of artificial intelligence in data science lab, or say, like, you know, in making this oxygen concentrator. So when I write another paper after 6 months, so what I will do, I'll think, oh, this is my own paper. So I can take, you know, few things about the oxygen basis, whatever I use, those basic things, if I use, you know, in my paper. So what is the thing, if you even you want to take anything from your own paper, you have to make quote unquote and say Patakama 2012, Patakama 2000, because see, software may not realize it is your own paper. If you take something, if it is quote unquote, it will be considered. But if you don't make it, it will be shown as a similarity before submission, and after submission, once it gets published, of course, publishers are, you know, check everything, and it's not easy, you know, even they will simply reject such manuscript. So in this case, you need to be very particular, and you need to properly, you know, cite those things. There are many, you know, kind of plagiarism we know. Even I have seen papers, you know, there are 12 paragraphs in that papers and 10 paragraphs there from somebody else's paper, introduction from somebody else's paper, you know, then particular that topic information is from somebody else's paper, and they are making proper quote unquote everything. So this is a basic, actually software may say he had 10% similarity only, but this is highly unethical. So that case also, you know, you need to be particular. So there are various types of, you know, plagiarism, clone, control C, find, replace, all those things, remix, recycle, hybrid, 404 error, particularly people, you know, remove some dot or slash from the references. So it will look like a proper reference, but you click, it will not work because, you know, intentionally some mistake has been done. Now question comes, how to avoid, you know, plagiarism. So the, as I says, honesty is the best policy. And then, you know, to avoid any plagiarism, to use your own work as often as possible. And then quoting and citing sources usually required and inevitable when doing research. That is how backup your own work, but using someone else's work excessively can be construed as a similarity. Then proper quotations. So I think there are various styles, you know, as per what style you are filing, whether it is, you know, following, whether it is MLA, APA or Chicago. So this. Then who detects the similarity? Of course, we know there is a softwares like Turnitin, Urcon. Then there, you know, one can, your reviewers can also check there is a similarity. And then readers who are reading your manuscript, suppose it get published and somebody, you know, author is, you know, reading whose work you have quoted. So that also can make out. Google also can make out. So all those things are there. So as I said, how to prevent, we need to understand between the common knowledge and original ideas. I think you know about these things, right? There's also one, common copyright policy. So I think I'll discuss about those things. So common knowledge, like somebody says, you know, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was the first prime minister of India. If you say somewhere in this paper, it is not a similarity because, you know, it is a common knowledge. Everybody knows there is no original idea, right? So we need to understand, you know, about the common knowledge and original ideas. Then, yeah, of course, do the right things, follow your, you know, conscience, then give credit, mark direct quotations and use reference citations. Even, you know, somebody is funded your research manuscript, you should acknowledge in the last, you should acknowledge your higher authorities, you should acknowledge your colleagues, you know, with whom you have discussed. I think we need to learn these things. And as I say, now we are doing better. As I say, now our rejection rate has come down to 61%. It is not like that, you know, in our country, it is 61. There are the most of the countries, their rejection rate is more or less same. Okay. So these are the possible consequences, you know, a scholarly reputation, self-concept, grades, dissertation not accepted. I think we everybody know about these things. You know, ministers had to resign due to similarity rule. So there are many cases, you know, this like, this was also on the Nature Medicine, it was published about Indian scientists, IMTEC, CSR lab, there was a case, Madras. So as I say, Indian scenario, now people are, you know, very much aware of those things. They are very much concerned about these things. And now, as I have seen now, you know, even the research scholars, they make sure that their similarity is not more than 10. Till that time, they keep checking again and again. But I think we know the one drawback of Urkund, that, you know, once you check any similarity and you don't delete from there, you know, it gets saved in there, you know, and next time you check, it will be shown 100%. Then you need to ask your nodal person of Urkund, and then the person will delete, and then again you can check. This is not the case, you turn it in a number of times, you know, you can check and you can delete. So coming to the last part of my presentation before I move to the online demonstration, this is the UGC. I think we everybody know aware about UGC guidelines, and there is a one by one you can check. Till now there is no consolidated list where, you know, you can go and check. This is the UGC guidelines has come, you know, and July 2018. So what it says actually, it is basically, you know, make sure that you should not do mistakes and all. Content to be checked, necessary research paper, dissertation, thesis, okay, and what should not be checked, answer script, coursework, you know, which do generally do not have any original ideas. So that is the reason all quoted work similarity check for exclusion. And a quoted work will not be considered, references, bibliography, table of contents, acknowledgement will not be. Why it will not be considered? Because there is no original idea. And quoted work, we already given acknowledge. So why it should be considered? Then generic terms, laws, standard symbols, standard equation, like EM to E equal to MC square. It will not be considered, right? So level of, you know, plagiarism. So this is, you need to be, you know, understand level 0 up to 10%, 1, 10 to 40%, level 2, 40 to 60%, level 3, 60%. So there is now two types. In case of thesis and dissertation, these are the levels. In case of academic research publication, these are the, I'll quickly say, like if you have up to 10% similarity, no penalty, nothing. But let me tell you one thing. If you have a 10% up to one reference only, then also, you know, you actually, the faculty member should ask the student that it is not good. 9% or 10% should not be from the single source. If it is like 1% up to 10 or 2, 3, 4, something, that is fine. Okay. Then level 1, between 10 to 40. Here, student will be asked to revise a manuscript. Okay. So, this, and then 40 to 60 dropped for a year, and above 60, the registration will be cancelled. So I think this should be, you know, one, the day a research scholar should join, I think we should tell them that this is the, you know, thing you need to follow. And this is in case of academics and research publications, up to 10%, no, 10 to 40, withdraw the manuscript. That is what I was telling. There are number of publishers, they do not allow you to withdraw the manuscript. And then you will end up in a problem. So that is the thing I keep telling, you know, our my fellow academicians, that you make sure that it should not exceed 10%. Of course, you know, this is generally in case of, but if you submit to the foreign publishers, generally they do not follow, you know, 10 to 40% because, you know, they have a different policies. Even I have seen up to 26% also they accept. Of course, you know, when it is really required, but you should acknowledge properly, you should quote unquote, all those things you need to follow. So these are where the UGC guidelines. Okay, now coming back to the softwares. So we know there are a number of anti-plagiarism softwares. There are free softwares also. But as I say, free software, especially in this case, they are good for nothing. Though I am a good fan of, you know, open source softwares, like, you know, there are open source softwares in content management, web making, design, website, library automation. But here, you know, actually a free software means their content, you know, back-end library is not very strong. They generally check which are, you know, freely available on the Google or internet. So if you really done any similar, there is any, you know, plagiarism, but it will say 0 or 5%. But you submit to the publisher, they will reject and they will say there was a similarity of 40%. So that is the reason anti-plagiarism software comes in the picture. Now, why they charge? Because see, they are the third party softwares. Suppose we know there are more than 5,000 academic publishers. So when we submit any, you know, manuscript in the software, it, you know, scroll through all the publishers' content server and it comes back. So for every hit to the server, publisher charge some amount to this software companies. That is the reason, you know, they are like, if you talk about Turnitin, it cost around 4 to 8 lakhs rupees. If you talk about Urkund, it cost about 1 to 1.5 lakhs rupees. So Authenticase, so at this moment, like all the CSR labs, they are having access to Authenticate softwares. All the old IITs, I have access to Turnitin software. Voice, I think, from Govind.
आवाज आ रही है, माइक बंद करिए अपना पार्टिसिपेंट्स प्लीज.
थैंक यू. सो लेट आई थिंक दिस पॉपुलर सॉफ्टवेयर आई विल टॉक अबाउट लाइक टर्निटिन एंड उर्कुंड बिकॉज दे आर वेरी यू नो एवरीबॉडी नोट अबाउट इट. एज आई सेड अर्लियर आल्सो, इफ यू वांट टू चेक एनी मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट स्पेशली टू टर्निटिन, यू कैन मेल मी, आई विल बी हैप्पी टू. So now Turnitin, I think I'll not go in theoretical. See, this is the, once you open Turnitin account, you need to create one user profile, being admin. So generally what we do, we get a data in Excel sheet and one shot we can create a account for the all our faculty members. Now there we need to one create a class and assignment. Okay, let me tell you one more thing. In case of Turnitin, you know, they have various models. Like you want to take a single user or multi-user. So if you want to take a single user, what you can do, like I have seen this in JNU, you know, one machine you can dedicate it for Turnitin manuscript checking through Turnitin. So whoever comes, they will, you know, Turnitin, how to use software, guidelines will be there, like same we have also implemented here. And then, you know, student can check and they can delete. Though we have given access to all the faculty members, but students we have not given. So students case, they can come and check in the library. Of course, they can also send the manuscript through the email. But they can also check, you know, themselves. So one need to create a class and assignment. This is only one time, and class and assignment also will be the dummy one, not the real one. So, you know, this is the minimum requirement of the Turnitin software, and then you can check any manuscript in the Turnitin software. Now, let me give the example. Like this is our Turnitin account. Like I have given one class name, Library Science. Okay. Then once I create a class, I have to, you know, create one assignment here, add assignment. The moment I say add assignment, then it is now, can you see submit button? So through submit, you can, you know, upload any manuscript in the Turnitin. Now, if you see carefully, there is a delete assignment. So you can delete any assignment. You can delete any paper. Okay. And then there is a edit settings. Edit settings means you can internally, when, you know, student has to submit the project and report, whether they can check the similarity report. So all those power you will have, admin powers. One more edit settings, very important. When you upload any manuscript, there is a whether you want to submit to the Turnitin repository or no repository. I strongly say it should be no repository, because if you submit to the repository, what will happen? I think we know, when we check the second time manuscript, what it will show? 100%. Another point, when you send the, you know, manuscript to the for the submission to any journal, and you have submitted as submitted to the repository, reviewer also or editor also, it will say 100% similarity. That case also they may reject. Another problem comes with the faculty members when they submit their paper to any preprint server. I hope you are getting my point. As you know, there are many preprint servers, like, you know, archive.org, bioarchives, agriarchives. There are a lot of preprint servers. So if you upload any preprint server, you may get one DOI number also. But, you know, once, so that is also, once you check, reviewers check your manuscript. I have seen here many cases. Publisher says, oh, there is a similarity of 70%, you know, report. So we reject your paper. Then though two faculty member had made a disclaimer in their cover letter that my paper was, you know, submitted to the preprint server. This is the DOI number. It is my own paper. Kindly, but still they, you know, they say they reject because they hardly spend their time. So you need to be very particular, you know, when you are submitting a such manuscript. So this is the like single file upload, inter turn it in. But I always, you know, recommend you, even there is a single file, you go to multi upload because, you know, you need not put the author name, first name, though you need not put your exact name and all, but still you, there is an option below multi file upload. So that, you know, straight away your file got uploaded. So the moment you file upload, it will come here, it will show file size, number of pages, words count. And once you submit, it will show here 31%. If it is a less, it will show blue. If it is higher, it will say green. If it is more, it will show red. So it shows paper ID, date, everything. Okay. So there is a, you know, this similarity, like there is a 30% similarity, this from various, you know, resources. Okay. And now there is a one option is coming, exclude resources. What is comma option here? Exclude resources. I forgot to put a screenshot. So suppose this one, the moment you say exclude resources, whatever is your own paper, you just tick and delete. So these papers will go. So 30% will come down to 10%. You are getting my point? Okay. So this you can do, excluding the, and it will not also come somewhere in report. Nowhere it will be reflected. But you, again, it is an ethical issue. If you feel this is your own paper, like I am a Sudipto Ghosh, okay, and I have this, so what I will do, these two paper I will delete because these are my own paper, right? So once I say exclude resources, checkbox will come everywhere. I'll say tick and exclude. So it will come down to 23%. Okay, I'll show you during the live demo. So this is all about Turnitin. And okay, red means 4% in this year, purple 3%. This is the pink one is here. This is the, okay. So all those things, you know, you can make out from colors. Even there is an option, if you don't want colors and all, it colors will not. This is, you know, for the, just for the identity to make sure, you know, from which source. Okay. If you click here, this particular source will be open here. Okay. This is the admin page of Turnitin, you know, where you can create an account for all the faculty members and all. You can add them as a, you know, instructor. So they are called as an instructor. So as you can see, our faculty members, you know, whether they are, what is their class ID and, you know, all those things. The grade mark is also there. Our, you know, that Turnitin is not, you know, we need to pay extra dollar for that. So right now we are not doing, but that option is Turnitin. You can grade mark also. And there is a one more very good features in Turnitin. Suppose, I hope I'm audible. So the, you know, like student has submitted a Turnitin, you know, this manuscript. So when, you know, I review it, I put the wise comments, you know, 3 minutes or 3 minute limit is there. Oh, very good, Santanu, you did a good job. But second paragraph, there is a grammatical error, kindly correct. And references part, you have not play, you know, followed the citation styles, kindly look into this. Or I'll save my audio message. So what will happen when Santanu will open the, you know, his report, this my wise message will be there. So he can hear my wise message. So what is the advantage? It will save my time. Okay. Then there is one more authenticate. As I say, it is as good as you know, Turnitin only. Live demo, I'll show you once this is over. Now the another one is the Orkun software. So I think everybody know new name is original. It was provided by Ministry of Education through InfibNet to all the universities, colleges, and then this rule has come. So this is the dashboard. This is the dashboard of the Orkun. Okay, and this is the various, you know, this color wise, you know, up to 15% yellow, you know, light yellow, dark yellow, orange, all those things. And this is the, you know, dashboard. Here you will see the, once you upload any paper, the 2% and all those things. Once you click, there's a delete option, but as I said, it will not be deleted. It will be saved in the repository. Here, you know, you can, this is how you can upload any paper. There's an upload document. By using upload, you can upload any document in Orkun software. I'll show you the live demo. Okay, once you submit, you will get one email alert that paper has been submitted immediately. And after some time, you'll get one more alert. Then this is the similarity. Okay, with the certificate. Then it will come like this, then there will be like this, okay, this and then it will show everything, how much is the similarity, why it is there is no similarity, because this paper was just submitted. Okay, here the settings, you can check settings and all. This is the kind of email you will get, okay, that you have has been submitted, and this another mail will come, like there is a 62% similarity. If you click here, this report will open. This is the kind of certificate you will get from now. It will come in the name of original.
Excuse me.
Hello. Hi. Yes. So this will be considered as your certificate. Okay. And with this certificate, you can submit your thesis to the your university. Okay. So this is the now I'll discuss. You know, there is a lot of things about Urkund and Turnitin. I'll discuss if I get a time. And now how to avoid plagiarism, I think I'll discuss once in the Avika. I now want to give a live demo. Okay, so I'll skip now these theoretical things. And now let me come to the live demonstration. Now I'm going to share my browser. Just give me a second. And then please keep ready your questions. Okay, so because you know, if you have questions, then only I'll feel, you know, that there was an interactive. Now I'm going to share my, okay. Can one of you can confirm whether you can see my Turnitin screen?
Yes, it is.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Now I'll say log out. So first I'll say Turnitin because, you know, many, a few of you must be using Turnitin or would like to use. Many of you are must be using original, but as I say, Turnitin already bought Urkund. So maybe after a few months, you know, the Turnitin name will be for all the softwares, or they may have two versions, low price model and higher price model. So this is the Turnitin.com. Okay. Browser, you can see Turnitin.com. Let me increase the 150. So Turnitin.com, right? Com is here. Yeah. So this page will come, then login. As I said, this is a paid software. So paid software means it is a subscription based. It price vary from institute to institute, depend on the size of the institution, number of users. Okay. Like in our case, I think we pay around around 3 lakhs rupees because it is the consortium negotiated pricing. Now I'll say login. So there is a two login. Once I log in from this thing, it is my online. Once I log in from this thing as an admin ID. Okay. So once I say login. Admin page also, anybody want to see, I'll show you. So this is the page of Turnitin. Now there is a like add, as I said, add class and add assignment. Okay. So nothing, once you click on the add class, you need to just provide, as I said, standard, you may give some name, dummy name also you may give, KJJ, okay, enrollment, something like this. Okay, like this. So now let me come here, how to upload a manuscript in Turnitin. So like this, already I made a class, entrance 2. Okay, now when I come inside in the assignments, there are two assignments, entrance 22 and MST. This already two papers have been submitted, and this 62 papers have been submitted. Now I want to see these two papers. I'll say view. And so this paper, how much similarity is there? 8%, right? It says green. And this, how much similarity is there? 31%. So see, color has changed. Now again, let me go back to the this thing. Okay, now you see when I click on the more action, I hope it is visible. Let me just increase the, you can talk, unmute and tell me if any issue, okay. More action, can you see this more action?
Yeah, it's visible, sir.
Okay. So more action, if you see, there is a edit settings, right? I was talking about in presentation, edit settings, submit and delete. Okay, delete means this, all those two files will go, or all these 62 files will go in one shot. Then you can also take a backup before that option is also there. So view, so there is a, before going to submit, how to upload, I'll say edit settings. Because see, this is very, very important, edit settings. So here you can, you know, if this is related to the students, you know, if you are going to, like they have to submit a project report. So a student can, you know, see, but they cannot, you know, they can submit online. So here you can put a date, deadline. Up to what time they have to submit, whether you want to submit only the any type of file, then you have to go to optional settings. allowed submission after due date. So this is all the, you know, prerogative of faculty members. I will not go into this. Exclude bibliography, yes, as per UGC guideline. Exclude quoted material, yes. These all things are inbuilt in URCON, okay, but not here. Exclude small sources, yes. I'll say 14 because it is as per the UGC guidelines, right? Then allow student to see similarity reports. Again, this is the jurisdiction of the faculty members. Submit papers too. It should be no repositories. Let me tell you again, no repository. If you make standard paper repository, I think then everybody knows what will happen. Your manuscript will be submitted to the Turnitin repository. And suppose if you want to delete from there, then you have to talk to the Turnitin administrator. Means mostly it is the librarian. And then librarian, you need to share your paper ID. Then paper ID, you know, will be shared with the this Turnitin team and they will delete. But let me tell you, they are very active. They'll immediately delete. It might also happen, you know, sometimes faculty member, they think, oh, it is deposited. So they think, let me delete complete paper. So they don't remember the paper ID also and they delete. That case, what will happen? Then we have to ask to the, you know, being admin, Turnitin admin, you have to ask to the Turnitin person, you know, the support team, you all reinstate his deleted publication. They will do this. Then you note down the publication ID. Then again, you have to say, now this publication ID will delete from the repository. It's a long process, but get resolved in 2-3 hours. Okay, is it clear? Now let me show you how to upload a paper. I'll try to finish in 15 minutes time. Now there is a, you know, this submit file. Can you see this? Submit file. From here, you can also submit. Or there was an option here also, more action and submit. So here also you can submit. Okay, single file I have seen. If you go to the multiple file, it will not ask anything, just file. So it will save your time. Go to the choose file, select anything. Suppose GI goes and I submit thesis chapter. Okay. This paper is getting uploaded here. Okay, generally takes less time, but it is a PhD thesis, complete PhD thesis. It may take 1 to 2 minutes time. Otherwise, it's very quick. And you can also upload here zip file. Okay, suppose you have a, you know, like 40 PhD thesis reports or MS thesis reports. So you can just upload as a zip file also. Okay. Upload. This is uploaded, accepted, yes, and say submit. So this file has been uploaded to. Okay, now see, after 2 or 3 minutes, similarity will be shown. Now let us take one example. Now let us take 31%. Okay, this file was submitted 5th June. Paper ID is this. So I'll just click on color, this color, okay, to download this paper. Now you see carefully, can you, just you, one of you may, our admin can unmute and whenever I ask you, because there will be a lot of pop-up, so you need to confirm whether it is visible. So it is visible, my, this pop-up, this PDF file?
Yes, visible.
Thank you so much. Yeah, so now you can see there is a 31%, right? How much similarity? 31. Let me see, if you click here, you can see what are those 31%. So you can see, oh, this is like, you know, 6%, 4%, 4%, 3%. Now, can you see here? What is the option here? Anyone, can you tell me?
No, sir, not visible.
Not seen, sir.
Oh, this is not visible, right? Okay, just a second. See, that was the thing. I was, you know, stop sharing. Sharing all. Now, you may confirm whether, can you see exclude sources?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, great. So see, now what we are going to do, this is the, like the Turnitin, see, let me again revise you. I am showing you the demo of Turnitin software. It is anti-plagiarism software and it is one of the most, you know, renowned or reputed anti-plagiarism software, which is used by most of the old IITs, IITs and NITs, ICERs and all. Now, when you click on the sources, why we should make exclude sources? When you feel it is your own paper, right? Self, you know, we will sell our similarity from our own publication. So you click on the exclude sources. Can you see now checkbox? Hello?
Visible, sir. Clearly visible.
Yeah, great. Now see, suppose I feel, oh, like see, generally this is your on paper, it will go at top. Right? This is, you can see red one. Otherwise, I feel, you know, because I'm giving you a, suppose these are my on papers, right? This many are my on papers. So I'll select and I'll say exclude. Because these are the self citation, right? So see, it has come down to 22% on, right? Again, if you wish, you can again say exclude and again you can delete, right? Am I clear? So this you can use in case of self citation. When you have knowledge, you can remove. Okay. Now, suppose this is done 20%. Okay. So now I'll say cut and here arrow, you delete and you click and you can download this PDF file. Turn it in report. Now I'm going to download from clicking over here. So we have not that version. Otherwise, once you click here, there is one option is coming where you can record your voice and you can see the, you know, grammatical error, all those things. So manuscript.doc. I think this, I don't know whether you're able to read. Are you able to see this new PDF manuscript.docx?
Right now, right.
It's loading.
Can you see this PDF? I'm scrolling.
No, sir.
Okay. I hope now it is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is the downloaded manuscript, downloaded plagiarism report of this manuscript. See, it shows submission date, submission ID, file name, everything is here. So even if you, when you give a file name, it should be very particular, right? That I think all those things, your roll number, everything should be there. As per the, see now, this is the thing will come here. So 20% is file. This is all what you must be thinking. So this is from the primary sources. This is from the secondary sources. This is from the tertiary sources. I have told number of times to turn it in. You know why you give this? This is, you know, very confusing. It should be only this. So these are the, you know. So what I will tell you, I don't know whether it is ethical or unethical. But what people do nowadays, you know, they just check their manuscript. Initially, they don't give any. I have seen this. It is, of course, unethical, actually. They check their manuscript in Turnitin or anything. Whatever references are coming, okay, all those references, they, you know, this in Turnitin, like these are the primary sources. All those things, you know, they quote or they mention in their manuscript. So generally, you know, they don't waste time. They get all these sources. Oh, this is from, you know, so they are, you know, like this, you may say like very practical people. So like this is too, they will quote, they'll see and they'll quote this, they'll quote this. Okay. All those references. So what is the advantage? If they may quote unquote all those references in the manuscript. So when they check again, it will be zero. Right. So this is the practice is also being followed. What I have written, seen the studies. So I think I'm done with the, you see one more thing in the, when you come in the last, it will show what you excluded. Okay, so it is not excluded means here excluded quote, yes, on excluded bibliography, on exclude matches less than 14 words. So whatever your excluded references, those are not being seen here. So that is your up to your, you know, this thing up to your consent, because you know reviewer and editor can again check your manuscript. So again they can check. Okay, so I think I'm done with the Turnitin. So any question related to Turnitin, or can we move to the Urkund? Because
no, sir, there are some questions regarding Turnitin also.
Yes. So I think you may ask them to unmute them and then, you know.
Or sir, actually, I'm reading out the questions.
Yes, ma'am. Please read out.
Okay. In Turnitin, common terms like is, was, to, as, show, they are showing plagiarized. So how can we avoid them?
Can you repeat, ma'am, your question?
In Turnitin, the common terms like is, was, to, as, they show as plagiarized. So how can we avoid them?
No, this actually it's showing, but you know, when reviewer, when he see, as I say, you know, up to the 14 words, right? Up to the 14 words, the continuation, there is no problem. Otherwise also, you know, when you will submit the, you know, this report with them. So it is the, you know, jurisdiction, it is the judgment of the reviewer. They also know this kind of, you know, propositions will be there. So you need not worry, actually. They take care of this. Yes, ma'am. Next question.
Should I ask all the general questions also?
General, I think we'll take in the last because okay. We have a output also.
Okay.
So Turnitin, again, I'll just revise in a 1 minute time. This is the Turnitin dashboard, Turnitin.com. Since we have a subscription, I am able to open this Turnitin. This is the once you upload, you can see this kind of, let us see, I'm going to refresh this page. Let us see whether, result is shown. I'll say reload. I hope you are able to see my screen.
Yes.
See, now it is coming 20%, right? How much? This we have just uploaded, right? No, this one, 5%, right? So 8 June, 5% only, okay? Then once it is done, you just download. If you feel like it is well good, 5%, you go ahead and submit. If it is more than 10%, you again need to revise. So now I'm coming to the Urkund. So I will say here urkund.com. I hope you can see my browser, right? Urkund.com. Right? There is a login button. I log in. Again, since we are having subscription to login, I am able to log in. I will say login to the web inbox global. Okay, see it is showing here original, but it is Urkund. So still, they are in transform mode. And I think after maybe 6 months or 1 year, they will completely, So this is the dashboard of original software. I'll say Urkund software. So these are the few folders. These are the few papers. Here also, if you want to upload any paper, what you have to do, there is a create or upload. Can you see here? Upload, right? Software. So I'll say upload files. I'll go again to G, same manuscript I will show you. Let us see now, thesis chapter. How much percentage was there? Turn it in, thesis chapter, 5%, right? Can you see this 5%?
Yes, sir.
Now let us see in Urkund how much it shows. Okay, it is asking for analytical address. This one, you can just leave like this, upload file. Let us see Urkund how much it shows for this manuscript. Okay, till it shows, and let us move ahead and let us take any other book. Okay, you can see many paper like one thesis. Oh, it has uploaded, but since it has not, it will take some time. There is no similarity. One paper from Symbiosis, as this paper's 30% and Aniket. So let us take any paper. Let us take from higher one that is like this 14%. Okay, let us see this paper. So see, once I click on 40%. It says word, similarity, file size, everything comes. Once I click on 14%. So here also we can do the same thing which we are doing in Turnitin, excluding resources and all, right? But Turnitin, nothing was shown, but in case of Urkund, this will be shown in your PDF. Okay, so now this is the paper. Now I think you can make out, right? What does it mean? Like first paper, there is a lot of similarity to second page at bottom, third page at upper hand side. So this is page by page also you can check, view all the pages, you can check like this. Okay. So this is page by page. There are the how many pages you can see at a glance. This is the total. You can see this is complete copy paste, right? Must be his own publication, 126. It is simple. See. Like as somebody was saying, AN for, this looks like this, there is no problem. But there is a complete blot, means something wrong is here. Okay, so reviewer will always see all those things. This is always ignorable. This is also like Indian Institute of Science Education, ICER Bhopal full form is, it will show everywhere like this. Okay, so now let us assess, let us analyze this report. So where I'll click here. Okay. Yeah, it will just take two more seconds. It generally depend on your internet bandwidth, your computer speed, net speed also. Yeah, so it's taking some time. So meantime, one question we can take, ma'am, related to the OCode software. Yeah, it has come. Okay. So now see, once we download, it is getting saved in D file. Once you open, this is the certificate of OCode, 14%, right? But now question comes again, as I said, you want to. Just a second. Now we want to review this, before downloading is fine, 14%, but suppose you want to remove, any unwanted, this is the certificate, these are the resources, right? But suppose we want to review, see, like we are able to remove few citations there. Let us do here also. So let us take any file, let us take this one only. Open reports. Are you able to see this? What is happening? Loading and all?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay.
Great. Yes, sir, visible.
Okay. Thank you. Now let us see here. You can see here 200 matching text. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So if you see here, click on the matching test, can you see findings, sources, entire document, right? And what is the similarity right now? 14%, hai na? Kitni hai? 14%. Ab isko hum log kam karte hain. Agar hume self citation ya hume kuch resources, toh hum kahan pe click karenge? Sources. Kahan click karenge? We'll click at sources. Okay? Now you see, we have seen in Turnitin, checkbox, click and deleting. Now in here, what we will do in sources, like finding sources, entire document. See, once you need to spend more time on such things, to get expertise. So where it is going, first one, 10.26%. Dekhi, inhone text kahan se liya hai? Sodh Ganga se liya hai, na? Sodh Ganga repository se, right? 10%, 10.26. And if you see here, this is the location in the document. Yahan pe hai. Aur matching text kitna hai? 102. Okay. और ये यहाँ पे अगर आप क्लिक करेंगे तो ये गो टू द सोर्स बताएगा, मतलब ये सोर्स में कहाँ, मतलब किस सोर्स से लिया, क्लिक करेंगे अगर सोर्स में तो ये देखिए ओरिजिनल सोर्स आ जाएगा नंबरिंग के साथ. वुड यू लाइक टू गेट द फुल थीसिस फ्रॉम सोर्स गंगा अलोंग विद साइटेशन? यस. ओके, एंड वंस यू गो यू कैन चेक एंड यू कैन डाउनलोड दैट चैप्टर, बिकॉज वी नो एवरीवन, ओके, वी कैन डाउनलोड दैट पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर. दिस इज द ओपन. ओके, सो नाउ लेट अस कम टू हियर. देखिए आप ध्यान से सुनना आप लोग. मान लीजिए कि ये 10.26% हमें हटाना है. मान लीजिए कि मेरे ही पेपर सब ओके, इट इज अ सेल्फ एडिशन. सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल क्लिक ऑन दिस एरो एंड आई विल से हियर अनटिक. ओके, अगेन दिस इज एथिकल इशू. इफ यू फील वेरी मच इट इज फ्रॉम योर पेपर ओनली, देन यू शुड. सो इट इज नाउ 00. ठीक है, अब आप देखिए 14% का कितना परसेंट हो गया, अब ये 4% है ना. कैन यू सी दिस?
यस,
है ना. फिर से मैं बताता हूं, अगर मैंने इसको फिर से हटा दिया, एज इट इज कर दिया, ये माउस से आपको बस क्लिक करना है इधर. ओके, सो दिस इज नाउ बिकम 4%. अगर आपको लगता है ये पेपर भी मेरा ही है, इसको भी आप जाके और यहाँ पे इसको अनटिक कर दीजिए. ठीक है, सो अगेन दिस विल बी फर्दर ड्रॉप डाउन. आपको लगा अब ठीक है 3%, अब आप इसको डाउनलोड कर दीजिए, आप डाउनलोड करके जमा कर दीजिए. ठीक है, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट OCode सॉफ्टवेयर. सो आई थिंक नाउ सेशन इज ओपन फॉर क्वेश्चन आंसर. लेट मी शो यू जस्ट रिपोर्ट, जस्ट ए सेकेंड. आप लोगों में से किसने, जिसने कभी ये एपीसी पे किया है, आर्टिकल प्रोसेसिंग चार्जेस, कोई है ऐसे फैकल्टी मेंबर? एपीसी होता है ना, सपोज जैसे आपको अगर अपना आर्टिकल ओपन एक्सेस करना है, इट्स अ जेन्युइन लाइक नेचर के नेचर, देयर आर रिनाउंड पब्लिशर्स, वेयर ये रिपोर्ट आ गई है, इसको हम करते हैं. सो इट्स नॉट इट नथिंग टू रिलेटेड विद द प्रेडेटरी थिंग. इट इज दे टेक देयर आर्टिकल प्रोसेसिंग चार्जेस. What is the advantage of gold open access? Your article is accessible, open accessible to everybody. राइट फ्रॉम द डे वन, ये देखिए 3% है ना। तो पहले वाली रिपोर्ट कितनी आ रही थी अपनी, 14%, है ना, नाउ इट इज 3% ऑनली, राइट। So I think now session is open for question answer. Yes, ma'am. Over to you.
Sir, regarding this original, there is a question. Is it a free account?
Free? No, ma'am. As it's I let me again. I think I made it very clear. Like Urkund and this Turnitin, both are the paid softwares. Suppose now Sultana, ma'am. Suppose you are a librarian of the ISA Bhopal. So what will happen? You will be the nodal person of Urkund. Urkund has freedom. Urkund, you can create an account not only for the faculty members, you can also create an account for the students. That is the one privilege is given by in the Urkund software. So those who are listening me, having access to Urkund, you have every right to ask your nodal person that, you know, you should have an account in your Urkund software. So it is a paid one, ma'am. It's not, you know, means they have to contact to Infinet Center Ahmedabad if they want to have access to Urkund software. Yes. Any next question?
Yeah, sir, there are two similar questions. Once they submit a chapter or a paper in Urkund, so in order to avoid 100% plagiarism for the second time, how can they remove or delete that paper or chapter?
No, can you repeat? I didn't get your question.
Once they submit a paper or a chapter,
box, ma'am, in chat box, I can ask it along with you. It is in the chat box. Hello.
While submitting for the second time, how can they remove or delete?
It is in the chat box, ma'am, that question, because your voice is, you know, breaking. So I'm not able to. This question in the chat box or?
Yes, sir, it is in the chat box.
Okay. The last one, ma'am?
No, it is quite.
Okay, ma'am, you can read out, ma'am. Yeah, please read out slowly so I can listen carefully. Yes. Sultana, ma'am, can you read out the question? Or that question you can copy again in the last so I can see. Hello. Am I audible?
Now you are audible, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Can you copy that question and again, paste in that.
Sir.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll do that.
Okay, your voice is little
slight. There are two similar questions. Sir, I'm putting it in the chat box.
Yeah, please. As I can say, meantime, how we can get access to, I think you are come now. Sir, when we write literature, this one, man, right? When we write literature reviews or other research papers, while explaining the materials and methods, results that they have obtained, there is a certain percent of plagiarism. How to get rid of this? See, when you are mentioning, explaining any material or method or results, right? You need to acknowledge, you need to, you know, properly cite. Until unless you cite, how software will come to know whether it is an original idea or if you have copied from someone. Okay, before it goes to the similarity. So once software check the similarity, you have not made quote unquote, it will think like, you know, it is, you are claiming your own idea, and it will check with the original software. So it is my sincere request, you know, when you are taking any result, it is your own results, it should not, you know, match with somebody else, because it is your original idea. But you take few lines or something, either you change your, my write your own language or just make quote unquote. That is what from my side. Then it says, you know, is there any software or site that can help me to read out plagiarism? See, as I said, you know, honesty is the best policy. Why you are asking, that your similarity should be not shown, or if your similarity should be, if you are, you have put your original idea. See, that is the reason, you know, research, when you do something, it should be your own word. So when you check similarity, it will take you to the original source from where, you know, it has, if you feel like, you know, that is, it is your original, and it should not so match actually, if it is your original words. If it is matching, means you have copy paste, but still you feel, then you can put a disclaimer. I have seen the paper, they put disclaimer, you know, ki still it is shown from this software. And what they do before that, they communicate with that author. If author is alive, that, you know, this is my own, it is matching with your manuscript. So if kindly confirm you do not have any objection, that authors give, you know, the consent. Generally, one more case, suppose there is a, like the Dr. Satpute, I can see, suppose his own paper, I take one paragraph, one image from his, you know, paper, and I put in my paper. In that case, I need to take first his consent in writing. I'm going to use your one of your image in your, my, you know, whether. In few cases, even author cannot give consent. You have to take consent of publisher. So it's very, you know, it's a, so there is a one Sherpa guidelines. If anybody want to have such kind of, you know, things, want to know which publisher is having which policy. If you have a Google, just say Sherpa guidelines and type the name of the journal. It will clearly show whether those articles you can save in your repository, yes, yeah, no. Whether you can share with someone, yes, yeah, no. Whether you can upload full text in ResearchGate, yes, yeah, no. All those ready guidelines are there. Yes, Sultana, my next question you can take.
Sir, they want to know the difference between patchwork plagiarism and paraphrasing plagiarism.
I think I cleared in my PPT when I was giving a presentation, and I'll share the my PPT. So everything I have given with the example, so they can go through this. But as I say, regarding paraphrasing, you know, means you are doing some, as I say, one tool, you are putting the synonyms and all. So, and all those things. So I have given details in my presentation, they can go through. I'll just share the PPT with this after my this presentation.
So there's another question.
Yes, ma'am.
When we write literature reviews of other research papers, while explaining their materials and methods, results, they have obtained certain percentage of plagiarism. How?
Yes, yes. Review literature, see, you need to just everything, you need to give quote unquote. There is no choice you have. This is the
we get rid of it.
Yes, ma'am. I got this thing. Because see, it undoubtedly, there is no question about this. Suppose I take one paragraph, say, like from Dr. Pradeep, sir, Pradeep paper. So what I will do is one paragraph, when I say as a literature review something, I have to say quote unquote and then say Joshi Kama 2002. Right, okay. So there is no choice, you have to make quote unquote. Am I audible, Sultana?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Srivastava. Sir. Let me take some question from chat box. It seems, I think, Sultana ma'am has some network issue.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, Nisan. Yes, Nisan. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I was actually raising my hand, and I think Sultana madam was not able to see.
Okay.
I'm faculty at IPS, and my question is about the confidentiality. Now, when we are doing similarity check, we are going to disclose our idea on a third party software, with third party, in fact.
Mm-hmm.
So what is the level of confidentiality that is maintained by this software, both paid and unpaid? This is my first question.
Okay.
And second question is about some information which I would like to know, because I was recently submitting some research proposal to the funding agencies. So as you know already that they require this certificate signed by the project investigator, principal investigator. Now, sometime we have access to some software, and sometime we do not have access to the software based on where we are located actually. So can I use a certificate that my university doesn't have access, for example, and I could ask, for example, I have a collaborator that could give me a certificate, authenticate, for example, or if they're not part of the research proposal, then can I ask them?
Yes, sir. I got your both the questions. Okay.
And it can be submitted, yeah. It will be accepted or not. This is the second question.
Sure. Thank you, Nishant, for asking your good questions. Actually, two practical problems with this thing. Let me answer the second question. There is no problem if you get a certificate from somebody else. Okay, it doesn't matter whether certificate is from your institution or some other institution, because it's a software certification. Okay, so this thing is very clear. You may also mention that, you know, since your institute do not have access to this software, for example, you send me the, you know, manuscript or turn it in check. And what I will do in like, in we cannot certify in like, in my case, I'll do this problem, I'll also tell you. I'll give the, you know, the report, Turnitin report to you. You may consider as a certificate and you can send them. But there can be few librarians, you know, who may sign and certify, because certificate itself, you know, it's a printed one from the site. So there is no problem. The research proposal, you know, they will definitely, because I get such reports from, you know, from my other friends, colleagues, and I. So I have not gone through, come across through, they have any problem. Now we are coming back to the first question about the originality, confidentiality. So let me see you, I'll give you one example, recent one, our PhD students, you know, she came and she said, sir, this is my, you know, this PhD report, and, you know, I want to check. She was writing one paper and she says, sir, you make sure nobody else can see, you know, this similarity. So I told her very clearly, see, this is when I'm checking this dashboard, it is between me and the dashboard only, nobody else, because I'm using from my login. And we know this is a very sensitive data. So what is request for from my side to you, Nishant, you know, when you ask someone to check the similarity on behalf of you, it is your duty to make sure that person, you know, how much, you know, whether you can really trust that librarian or that person. Tomorrow you should not say, oh, you know, it has got someone because, you know, that person has checked. So you should give your manuscript to check to the whom, the person who you really trust. Number one. Number two, let me tell you, there is no problem. There is no, like, for example, I'm checking your manuscript. Okay. I'll check in the Turnitin, I'll send you back. So it, you know, because being a librarian, I need not, I will not be taking even your papers, because our, you know, issue is that just to quickly check in a few seconds, you know, or minutes, and send you as quick as possible. But if you send to the, your person who is working in your area only, who is having Turnitin account, you know, there may be chances that it is between the person actually. Here, I cannot give the exact answer that, you know, what other person will do, who will. But generally, nowadays, nobody will do such things. This is my, you know, perception behind this. But you should make sure that when you have such doubts, you may be, you know, you are like, you have question, ask the question on behalf of all the participants. So that, you know, researcher should send a such query to the librarians only who is having that access. So that case, I consider it is, it is. Yes.
Yeah.
Pathak sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Pathak sir, there is no question. Thanks for coming this, your speech. And sir, time is over. So can we stop the your lecture, please?
Sure, ma'am. I'll just conclude by saying that my email ID is skpathak@icrb.ac.in. It is my PPT also. I'm sure you must be having many questions in your mind. Please communicate me through email, or my mobile is also there, mobile number. You please call me and I'll be happy to help you. If you have any other questions, I'm always available, and I enjoy talking to, sharing my expertise with research community. So please feel free calling me. Thank you so much. Thank you once again. For giving me this opportunity, and it was my, you know, pleasure to share the screen with all of you, all the eminent professionals. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, thank you so much. We'll be post mailing you the questions which are coming to you, so that we can communicate with you.
मैं बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ संदीप पाठक सर के, जो आज वो हमारे यहाँ पर आए और हमारे बीच उन्होंने बहुत स्पेशल सॉफ्टवेयर के बारे में बताया, रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स एंड पीएचडी स्कॉलर्स जो हैं उनके लिए. सो थैंक यू सो मच संदीप पाठक सर, थैंक यू सो मच.
सो ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन of Science and Research and Organizing Committee, I sincerely thank our resource person, Dr. Sandeep Kumar Pathak sir, for being with us in this session and enlightening us with such an interesting topic. I believe it will help us to solve many issues we are facing during our publication of manuscript. We shall be in touch with you surely in future, sir. I express my heartfelt gratitude to our principals and all the heads, participants especially, for their presence and participation. My heartfelt thanks to the organizing committee and technical committee for their wholehearted support in rendering the success of this session. Thank you all very much. The The next session will be at 2 p.m. So please, participants, please join with the link which will be provided in the group. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir.